Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Lab. Few days back, I have posted a video where I have explained how you can install IntelliJ in your Cloudera Quick Start VM. Now, a few of my subscribers have requested me that after installing, how I can configure the IntelliJ to get started with our Scala and Spark development. So in this video, I'll tell you how you can easily set up your IntelliJ IDEA for your Spark and Scala development. If you haven't yet installed the IntelliJ in your Cloudera VM, please watch my previous video. You'll get the link in the description and the I button. So let's go ahead and set up our IntelliJ for Spark and Scala development. I'll switch to my Cloudera Quick Start VM. Let's open our IntelliJ. So this will be the very first screen that you will see if you have not created any project. So here you need to click on Create New Project. Once you get this dialog box, make sure you select Scala from the left pane and SBT from the right pane. And click on Next. Give your project name. This will be your project location. Here you have to mention your JDK. It will automatically pick up if you have your default JDK setup. If you have not yet installed the Java JDK, I'll mention the link for JDK installation for different OS in my description. You can follow those simple steps and set up your JDK. And if you have already set it up, it will automatically pick up your default JDK. Now leave other options as it is and click on Finish. It will take some time in setting up the project structure, so wait until this setup is done. You will get green ticks once everything is done. So here you can see the setup is done. Here you can expand your project folder. Here you will see your basic SBT project structure. This is your project directory. You can expand it. This contains your build.property. Again, this is your source folder. Source folder again contains main and test directory, and both main and test directories will have a Scala directory, which is your sources root. This is your external libraries directory. Whatever new jar files are downloaded with the dependencies you added will come under external libraries. Now let us discuss some small key points that you need to take care in your project structure. First thing is, what is sources root? Sources root in a project structure depicts that this folder is eligible to take the source code. For example, I'll show you, this is showing as sources root. Also in a Scala project structure, there can be two types of sources. One is main source and one is test source. So you need to make sure that you are building your code and packages in the source folders only. The project structure is by default the source, but the correct practice is to create your code and packages under your main or test directory depending upon what type of code you are developing. You can see here, only under the Scala folder, if I right click, I'll get the option to create a Scala class or object. If I right click on SRC folder and try to create a Scala class or object, I won't get any option. Similarly, under main folder or any other folder, I won't be getting this option. For the test code also, under test root folder, I'll be getting an option to create Scala class. So this is the correct folder structure that you need to follow and place your source code under these directories. There is one challenge here, which many of you might have faced or might face after trying this. You won't get any option to create new Scala class even under your source directory or your test directory. You will only get this option under project build. So if you face such kind of issue, do not panic, because if you Google it out also, you won't get any satisfying answer. Few people might say that you can right click on source and mark your directory as sources root. There is no point of that. Sources root are blue in color. Test sources root is green in color. And we already have our Scala folder as a sources root. You cannot make it a source root. Similarly, this is already by default a test root. Also in some answers, you might be suggested to right click and add framework support and add SBT libraries and all. So I would suggest there is no use of all those things. We have already selected SBT while creating our project. So ignore all that. In such cases, the issue is with SBT default configuration that sometimes create this kind of misbehavior. In such cases, try to create a package or class under your project directory. And once that directory is created, try to drag and drop to main directory. Or by default also, when you create a new class under your project sources root, you might get an option to import the SBT again. Once you import the SBT again, the structure would be refreshed and you'll start getting this option. So let's say you have created this folder structure. Now let us see how we can start developing a simple Scala code, and then further we will see how we can include our Spark code also. So let's create a Scala object. Setup demo. Click OK. So this is our object. Let me increase the font. For increasing the font, you can go to File, Settings, Editor, Font, and increase it. Let's say 20. So let's create a main class. Let's create a simple array. And just sum it up. Array dot reduce and add everything. And let's do println. Let's try to run this. You can see we are getting the sum. So our simple Scala code is working well and good. Now let's try to include Spark into this project and get started with Spark coding in Scala. As you know, we are using SBT, so we have to add Spark dependencies for SBT project. Let's see where we can get those. You can simply Google Spark code dependencies for SBT. You can go to Maven repository site. Here it might bring you to some specific version of the dependency. You can go back org Apache Spark. Here, depending upon your requirement, you can add those dependencies. Like for basic Spark features, you can use Spark Project Core. If you want to use data frames, Spark Session and all, you can use Spark Project SQL. All the required libraries are available here. Let's include Spark Project Core. We have to import these dependencies into our build.sbt file. You can find this under your main directory, build.sbt. You can see here our Scala version is 2.12. Let's go back to Maven repository. This is for Spark Project Core. And here you can see the version of Scala you need it for. So we have 2.12. Let's click on this. Here you can get the dependencies for different build tools like Maven, Gradle, SBT, etc. So we have SBT. Let's copy this. Go to our build.sbt and just paste it. Here you will get option to import changes. What import changes does is, we have just mentioned a string in build.sbt. Now this action is on IntelliJ that it reads this file, go to the specific repository that is Apache Spark, download the mentioned dependency of this version. So the structure is like the repository, the dependency and the version. So once we click on import changes, Spark core dependency will be downloaded from Apache Spark repository and the version will be 2.4.3, whatever is compatible with Scala 2.1. You can also enable auto import. This function will help you in auto importing all the libraries as and when you paste this string into build.sbt file. So let's click import changes. It will take some time. Once the importing and indexing is done, the libraries are added to our project. As I told you, whatever libraries you import externally will come under external libraries folder. I'll try to show you. You can see all the Spark jars are included with the help of these dependencies. Now let's try this. I'll try to create a Spark conf. Well, new Spark conf. You can see IntelliJ is already suggesting to import this function from Apache Spark dependency. Once you click on this, the statement to import that library will be automatically imported. So Spark conf, let's set master, set it to local, set app name. These are a few basic things. Now let's create a Spark context. new Spark context. You won't be getting these options until and unless you haven't imported the Spark dependencies. Let's give it the Spark conf. Now let's do the same thing but with Spark. So we'll give sc.parallelize and same array, I'll convert it into an RDD. Fine. Now let's try to run this. You can see now Spark engine is started and same computation will be done with the help of Spark. You can see here we have got the sum 10, 20 and 30. So I hope you got the steps. It's very simple. You have to set up IntelliJ. Just maintain your project structure as I explained. And if you want to simply code in Scala, just create a Scala class or object and straight away you can start coding with it. And if you want to use Spark APIs like RDD data frames, you can go to Maven repository. Add those dependencies to your build.sbt file, import those downloaded jars into your classes and objects, and start using the functions inside that jar. So guys, if you still have any confusion, let me know in the comment section. If you liked this video, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. Thank you guys. See you later.